cryptocurrencies, tokens, coins, assets. I know you've heard all of that terminology, and I bet you have been wondering what the differences between all of them are. Today, I'm going to be explaining the difference between all of that terminology. I'm Limor, and I'm going to show you how to crush it with your finances. Come on, this will be fabulous. It can be so confusing to understand the difference between tokens and coins and assets and currencies. And today, my goal is to explain to you a little bit about how it works and how to be able to decode and tell the difference, because a lot of them are used interchangeably. So the best way for me to be able to explain this to you is actually in two various dimensions. The first one is going to be structured through the technology and how these various elements are actually built and constructed. And the second one is going to be around how we actually use it. So let's dive in. The first one is around how the technology is created. So in reality, there's basically, if I were to really simplify this, two main ways that these types of elements are created. The first one is coined, and the second one is a token. And let me explain them both. Coins, in the way that they are built, are based on their very own blockchain. They tend to have their own rules, their own protocol, their own sort of strategy behind how they were created. And I might even go so far as to say that a coin actually is almost an entity unto itself. And so examples of coins are things like Bitcoin or Litecoin or Ethereum. But Ethereum is actually a little bit of a tricky one because there's a couple of different elements to it. So I'll touch back on that throughout this video. But when you think about all of these coins, they really are distinctly separate. And one of the elements that's really important to understand is that they actually all have their own blockchain. I know sometimes we just kind of say, oh, the blockchain, but there's actually lots of different the blockchains. And so each of these coins are actually built to live as a separate component on its own separate blockchain. And these are a little bit more complicated to be able to develop and create. Now, the second one is called a token. Now, a token is actually, from a technology standpoint, built on somebody else's blockchain. So they're leveraging some existing technology and to be able to just overlay elements. And kind of the easiest way for me to explain this, or how I like to think about it, is kind of like YouTube. Of course, here we are on YouTube, is that I can have my own channel, you can have your own channel, and everybody who creates content on YouTube has their very own channel, but they're not recreating YouTube onto itself. So if you think about the coins, that would be like a separate YouTube. But if you think about a channel, it leverages the structure that YouTube already has. So in the same way, a token leverages the blockchain of somebody else. One of the most popular ones is Ethereum. Now, not to be confused, because they have their own coin called Ether, and they also have a platform with a technology spec that a lot of developers use called ERC20, and that's essentially where a lot of the tokens are actually created or based upon. Now, as a result of that, you can probably imagine that there's way more tokens than there are coins out there, but there's definitely a ton of both. And as I mentioned earlier, creating a token is far simpler because you're already leveraging the blockchain that's in place. So to recap so far, from a technology standpoint, we basically have coins and we have tokens. Within the usage component of all these elements, it can be really convoluted. It can be really confusing because there's a lot of interchanged words or different understandings of what these mean. And so let me explain them. Now, there's three that I'm going to be going over, and the first one is, of course, currency. Currency, currency, currency. We hear that all day long. And essentially, with a currency, one of the most common views out there is that you use the word currency for a transaction. So if I'm going to take some of my crypto that I've got and I'm going to trade it, or I'm going to barter it for a good or for a service, well, then that's the definition of a currency, right? There's going to be some transaction. Now, anytime you're transacting, which means you've either got a coin or you've got a token and it represents an element of value, and you're switching it for your product or your service, that's when you can be called a currency. And that's one of the most common views of cryptocurrency out there. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't also acknowledge that on the other side of the coin, no pun intended, of the cryptocurrency debate, there is a school of thought that really just thinks that currency is more as storage of value. And that's really essentially thinking that, you know, when you go to the store and you're gonna buy milk or you're gonna buy eggs, yeah, you're transacting, but the storage of value is really more about the value in the background. So let's say, for example, like gold. Gold could be the value. You're not gonna take that gold and go to the store and buy your milk and buy your eggs and buy your bread, but you're gonna use that gold in order to be able to accumulate your wealth, maybe personal wealth, generational wealth. And so there is a sentiment out there that, you know, currency is really for holding for the long term and for creating wealth. I'm not here to say what's wrong or what's right, but, you know, some of the way that I've been using the terminology is really that currency is about the transaction. So as I mentioned already, currency, because you're trading for value, it can either be a coin or it can be a token. Now, the second usability or way that you can use these is called a token or a utility token. And so this is often used when you have sort of access to a particular type of platform where you need to have that kind of token to enable you to get in the front door to be able to use it. So at a very simplistic level, if I were to create, I don't know, Limor's gaming arcade, and in order to play all of the video games in my arcade, you need to have the Limor token, well, there'd be some value around the Limor token, and you'd need to be able to have that if you wanted to come to my gaming arcade and be able to play or be able to participate. So that's a simplified example, but there's many out there where you need to have the actual token in order to gain access, to participate, to get the app, or whatever the activity is that you may need to do. So typically a token is a token. Now the third one is an asset or a crypto asset. And so this is typically used when there is an actual asset in the background. Again, it may be gold, but in this particular example, to make this really fun and easy, let's talk about jelly beans. So let's say that I'm creating 1 million coins that correspond to 1 million jelly beans. And each coin is connected or has the value of one jelly bean. Now that value could go up or that value could go down, but if there's only 1 million coins and there's only 1 million jelly beans, well, there's a representation of a one-to-one value. And so essentially, when you hear about crypto assets, there's usually some sort of asset in the background. Now, with this, sometimes there's challenges regarding trust because, you know, if you, in my example, wanted to have a coin that was equivalent to one jelly bean, it may or may not be easy for me to prove that I have 1 million jelly beans. And secondly, if you wanted to convert that coin or trade it in for the actual jelly bean, that may or may not be an easy thing to do. So know that this does exist, particularly in commodities, but I have seen a whole bunch of other examples as well. And again, in the same vein as the currency, a crypto asset can actually be, from a technology standpoint, either a coin or it can be a token. A question that I've been wondering about, and maybe you're wondering about as well, is there going to be a winner? Is there going to be one currency or coin or token or asset that's really going to be the front runner in terms of where we go and the one that becomes maybe of the highest usage? And to this, I actually got a really great answer from a friend of mine, Steve, who actually said that there isn't only one currency, so why would we ever get to a place where we have one cryptocurrency? And I agree with him. I think that's a really good point, that we've already got a ton of currencies already by country, by geographic region, and we do just fine with multiples. So it's not necessarily about having one winner, but having what we need in order to be able to achieve our outcomes or achieve the transactions that we're looking to get to. So, in conclusion, if you're looking to understand What is the point of all this? Essentially, what you really want to focus on is what is your desired outcome? What are you looking to do with your coins or tokens or assets or currencies? And just really ensure that what it is you're trying to do, whether it's gain access or barter for products or services, you can in fact do with either the coin or the token that you are thinking of buying or acquiring or the ones that you already have. If you are considering putting your money into either an ICO or a new project or, you know, maybe even an existing one, it's important for you to really understand from an evaluation standpoint, what is its background, what is its technology, what is its functionality, especially if you're looking to hold for a longer period of time. You want to make sure that it's one that is viable and really just meets all of your needs. I hope that this helped, even though in reality, the majority of us are interchanging these words all the time, but at least you'll know in the back of your mind what they actually mean and the purpose and the utility behind them. So if you like this video, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up and you clicked on the subscribe button as well as the little bell below that will notify you when I will put up the next video. As always, if you have questions, if you've got comments, if you've got feedback, if maybe you've got an insight that I didn't mention here today that is worthwhile sharing with other people, I would love, love, love if you share it in the comments below. And as always, if you're looking for more tips and tricks to help you with your finances, come on over to limor.money. I've got lots of great resources for you there. Remember, I'm not going to change who you are or how you live your life. I just have strategies to make you even more financially fabulous. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Till then, stay fabulous. So in theory, if you're trying to get a coin, if in theory it's a coin, oh no, I meant cryptocurrency. This is all so confusing.